Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com. And the question that came in today was, when do you discontinue twin block use? And this answer is really the same as a Bionator as well. So any type of class two and Invisalign with MA. And I actually already have a video made specifically for Invisalign with MA, but there's a few other funky things that can happen with Invisalign with MA. So if you're talking about that, listen to that video. If you want to search that video, you can find that in my Invisalign playlist, which is on my YouTube homepage. Or you can go to Straight Smile Solutions, go to classes, I think it's, or yeah, classes, and or education, and you'll find it there in my phase one playlist. But in a nutshell, I'm not going to go back and reinvent the wheel. You guys should know what a twin block is, what it does, how to design it, how to do the lab slip, all the different variations from your McNamara to your Clark. You should know all this stuff before you listen to this video. If you don't, you need to go listen to all my other twin block videos to find them again same way, or you can search by topic. If you go to my YouTube channel, Straight Smile Solutions, it has a green banner and over 10,000 videos. There's a little magnifying glass towards the top right. You can put in twin block and all my twin block videos will come up. Boom. Okay, let's get to the topic. So when do you discontinue? Well, two different points to that. Of course, the point of twin block is to correct from class two to class one. Now keep in mind that anytime you have class two to class one correction, there's some type of muscle memory that's in there. So even though it might look like she's class one, it's probably a little bit of muscle memory and shifting. So she probably isn't. So sometimes some orthodontists will take it away for a couple of weeks and see if they slip back before knowing if we're gonna discontinue it permanently. And that's kind of a good idea. Up to you. Or you're gonna wanna take it to the edge to edge point, which is a little overcorrected. So when you're using articulating paper, it's hitting edge to edge, you know, then that's a little bit safer. Always makes me a little nervous though, because what if there was no, you know, and then we really honestly overcorrected and now we have to do IPR or something. So I don't love that idea. So somewhere in between there is the right finish. You'll know your patient and you know a little bit more, but you know, it's gonna take probably about a half millimeter to a millimeter per month if it's actually being worn 24 hours a day. So that gives you some idea about how long it's going to take. So for a severe case, they might be wearing it for a year. And for a mild case, maybe only a few months. All right. Thanks so much.